friends, and welcome back to Jack's World of Wildlife. Now today, we are on the search for a most primitive creature. Now this organism is something pretty far off related to anything else we have ever filmed on camera. This is an ancient creature, a simple creature, but one that is great at doing what it's designed to do, and that is probing around in the night to hunt prey. Now we're in really good habitat, and I'm hoping we can flip one and show you one during the day. So we're gonna hike around. We've been hiking. We're already up on top of this beautiful little hill, and we're gonna be flipping some rocks, hopefully to find this spectacular creature. Now what's really peculiar about the animal that we're looking for is that its eyes are almost functionally obsolete. Now what that means is that this animal is essentially, for lack of a better word, blind. So it has modified front legs to help navigate, feel its surroundings, probe through the darkness and crevices of rocks, things of that nature, to get around and find food. Let's see if we can find one. All right, there's a little rock down here. We're gonna try and flip it, see if there's anything under it. You can come down. Goes so tight. All right, so I'm gonna flip this rock. Nothing. Now rocks are really good because they hold a lot of warmth from the day after getting baked in the sun. So both invertebrates and reptiles really seek refuge in these because they, being ectothermic, cold-blooded, need the extra energy that is stored for a prolonged period of time in these rocks once the sun goes down. All right, so we're gonna check up here now. We didn't have much luck up higher. So we're gonna check down here. It's a little wetter. There's some more insect activity. Of course, that is their main prey item. So let's take a look. It's like little crevices and things like these that they really like to get under. I'd really like to find a big one. Smaller ones are not as impressive. Nothing. Oh, actually, look right here, look right here. Guys, we did it! Okay, let's try and, easy. You're okay. This right here is a giant Vinegaroon. And they get that name Vinegaroon because out of this little tube, they actually shoot acetic acid, which smells and is pretty similar chemically to vinegar. Look at this creature, guys. This is a super, super primitive looking animal. So these are arachnids. So see, they have two main body segments, a cephalothorax and an abdomen, much like spiders and scorpions. But unlike spiders and scorpions, these long antenna-like appendages are actually their front legs. So these modified front legs act much like antenna. So you can see, probing around, trying to figure out where to go and what to eat. Now you see these large appendages in the front. These are actually this animal's pedipalps, which are appendages that a lot of arachnids have in front of their legs, usually used for mating in tarantulas. Oh, easy, you're okay. But in this case, they have become modified pincers. So it's basically these claws that come out and grab food, prey items, vice grip, and then their mouthpieces just cut it up, grind it up, turn it into a little bit of a slurry, and that's what they feed on. So they are fully carnivorous. Now, most scientists actually think that these guys have a lifespan comparable to female tarantulas, which means this guy right here could very well be 10 years of age. Honestly, one of my favorite invertebrate species out here. Let's get it on my face. That'll be good. They're often not hesitant to walk on any surface in front of them, which is interesting. Oh, he's scratching my eye. He's not very good at climbing. But, he does have sharp tarsal claws at the end of each leg to help him hook onto things. He's looking for a little crevice. He wants to live under my hat. You're okay. Don't spray vinegar in my eyes. Acetic acid. Get sprayed in the eyes with acid. That would be great. I want to see if I can get him to spray for you guys. Because I did not stress him out enough to get him to spray. Let's see. Oh, you're okay. He's not really interested in spraying. Okay. All right, well, we've had a lot of fun with this large male, so we're gonna release him back under this rock. Sun's going down. There's plenty of time to find more animals to film. So thank you. Thank you for cooperating, you beautiful, beautiful arachnid. One last look at that crazy creature. Almost alien, but right here in the great state of Texas. On this planet, that's right. Coming to a bedroom blanket near you. All right, let's move his little house back. He was having fun under here. And tonight, for soft-bodied invertebrates, maybe even lizards. I don't know, he might be feeling ambitious. There it is, there's your little house, buddy. So see how he uses those little antenna-like legs to, there he goes, find route he wants to go. All right, so that's exactly what I was looking for. Super cool. And I guess let's find some more stuff.